Hello, it's Polish Paul VR. In today's news video, we're gonna talk about Blade and Sorcery, Phasmophobia, Batman and Hitman 3. But before we start, a quick word from our sponsor, VRDoc Prescription Lenses. VRDoc are customized prescription lenses for MetaQuest 3, 3S, 2, Rift S, PSVR 2 and 1, HP Reverb G2, Pico 4, Xreal, Pimax, and various other VR, AR, XR headsets to correct vision problems such as nearsightedness, farsightedness, presbyopia, astigmatism, and amblyopia. VRDoc also provide anti-blue light lenses to protect eyesight for players with good eyesight. The installation process is very quick and very simple, and thanks to those lenses, you won't struggle with glasses in virtual reality and you won't scratch your lenses. All the links that you need are in the video description below, so head over there to order yourself a pair of those cool prescription lenses. It will improve your VR experience. You can use code PAULVR to get yourself a nice 10% off of your next purchase. Okay, let's go. First of all, let's start from Batman Arkham Shadow, releasing tomorrow on MetaQuest 3, looking awesome as fuck, and today, Elijah Wood, the Frodo himself, a man who doesn't age, revealed that he is playing one of the characters in the Batman Arkham Shadow. This game screams big budget, big time, a lot. So it's one of those VR, looks like it's super productions, awesome. Of course, Elijah Wood, he likes VR himself. He delivered a VR game in past, Transference, which was pretty fun, if not a bit too short, but fun. Anyway, moving on to other news, let's talk about Blade and Sorcery Nomad. This is for the quest owners, but also we're gonna speak about possible PSVR 2 version. So first of all, the brand new trailer dropped today. You can see it played in the background. And finally, after the 1.0 release on PC for Blade and Sorcery, they releasing 1.0 version for the quest players. So you're getting all the goodies in your game, all the optimizations, all the content. It is here. Now, I checked the roadmap of the game. Nothing changed. It still states that PSVR 2 version is possible after Nomad 1.0 release. Now it's released on PC, it's released on Quest. So it's possible that it comes to PSVR 2. Of course, possible doesn't mean it is coming. It might be something what the developers might do eventually, which I hope so, because more people deserves to play this game. Speaking about the games that deserves to be played, Phasmophobia got the release date, and the release date trailer plays for you in the background, coming to consoles as early access version on 29th of October. Just in Halloween for you and your friends to shit your pants together playing this game. Very popular PC title, very popular PC VR title, finally making its way to other headsets. And now let's speak about the game that turned up to be all hype but shit delivery from XR Games. They released brand new patch for Hitman 3 VR Reloaded. They added blood sprays and stuff like that. They added some fixes for the stuff that was broken. The game shouldn't crash as much when you're playing it, or even when it's loading. They managed to do some popping optimizations in some locations. Still some stuff don't work. The studio recently released most of their stuff, so I don't know who's working on fixes, like one or two people, I don't know. But they're trying their best to make it as good as possible as it can be. Saying that, Hitman 3, World of Assassination, all the games coming to PSVR 2 soon, with all the awesome PSVR 2 optimizations, so I cannot wait for that. But good news, that Hitman 3 getting fixed, because definitely this game deserves to be good. And Quest 3, especially, shows that they can pull off some awesome looking graphic. There is no excuse for this game to look like it looks now. It should definitely look better on Quest 3. Okay, that's it for today. If you're not subscribed, then subscribe. And thanks for watching. Bye.